Hello guys, my name is Fox and welcome to part 111 of our The Wrestling Campaign in Crusader Kings 2. Let's continue. So, in the previous episode, we've been continuing expanding our realm. We managed to pick up two more provinces, the province of Finnmark and the province of Suomi. So, now we're up to like 50% of the land from the Empire of Scandinavia, so we're getting slightly closer to be able to become an empire, but not close enough still. And yeah, I'm currently thinking about probably taking like this guy from Anniken. He's only one province, he have no allies, even though he's Catholic. Still, actually no, declaring a holy war on him probably not gonna be a smart idea, because Kazaria is also Catholic and he's bordering Kazaria. So Kazaria probably gonna help, so the best opportunity for me would be creating Duchy of Karelia. And that's probably what I've been thinking about last time, so let's wait a little bit on that. We already reinforced our troops. Also, I think I found out what was the problem with my son being shown as my heir. I think when the people voting for someone who is not from my dynasty, it actually means that he's gonna win the kingdom, and I'm gonna just be left with my direct holdings, like duchy and stuff. So that's why my heir shown is my son, because it means that I'm about to lose some of my holdings or some of my high titles. So let's it would be nice to try and prevent it. Let's go and look on who is voting for this guy. Smoland and Ventavit. Smoland is somewhere around here, right? Smoland, yeah. So if I were to improve relations with this guy high enough that he would vote for me, I think I might secure my succession. So let's go and try to improve relations with Smoland for now. Also, I think we got high enough to be able to get ourselves another one stack of retinue. And I think we should do this. Yeah, we could totally get another one stack. Unfortunately, our money situation is not too awesome. You could welcome back the juice, but we would need to have a lot of money to do this. So let's not for now. Also, we apparently have Queen of Sweden in our prison somehow. Interesting, why did not I notice that? We could ransom you for 10 ducats. I think it should be fine. I already took all the concubines I needed. So yeah, why not? And we have another one in here. Princess of Luki. Cool. Let's go and ransom you. And the rest just gonna stay in here. King Constant of Italy has set up an anti-pope. Huh. Okay. Good luck with that. And my concubine is pregnant, great. So, yeah, let's go and build up another one stack of resinous. Also, our lands is getting pillaged. Can't do much about that. Or actually, I don't want to do much about that because it will require me spending a lot of troops. And I don't really want it. Just let my vassals deal with that. They already burned down all the freaking holdings, so. Whoopsie. And actually, reinforcing this one stack is only 6 ducats per month, so I couldn't have positive income while reinforcing this extra stack. That's nice. But now we do not have enough money to create a duchy. Well, we could stay at peace for some time, right? And then we would need to find a way to somehow attack Bergslagen, Sweden, and all of these guys without them calling in all the entirety of Europe. And the only thing I have against them is holy wars, I think. Right? Actually, no, I have one de jure claim on Nidaros in here. But the rest of the duchies. Actually, also I have a de jure claim on Upland. And one of the de jure claims on Oslandet. Okay, well, that's not too bad. I have like 3 de jure claims, so I would probably press them before going to any holy wars. By the way, they still could call in all the holy orders and their allies into the de jure war even, so I would need to be picking my enemies carefully. Let's try avoid our son becoming gluttonous. We did not manage to do this, that sucks. And he's actually the one who is quick and gluttonous. That's some weird combination. Okay, is this freaking host gonna leave this place at all or not? He already burned it down, so why the heck you're staying in here at all? Okay, my daughter became kind, and actually this is the one who I'm marrying off to my heir. So that's nice, she's a genius, higher chances of you getting genius children, and maybe at some point I'm gonna be able to vote for one of these geniuses to place them. We also need an extra, excuse me, commander. So let's go and get some. Yes, you should be fine. Mm-hmm. Succession still seems fine. I hope. Yeah, now four people is voting for these guys. That's perfect. And another one daughter. Isn't that the same freaking event for the same daughter? That's strange. Maybe it was a different one. I don't know. Yeah, also we could create whole bunch of kingdoms and duchies, but we don't really have money enough for that. Okay, what is this? Urho's host. I think it is the one who is attacking Sweden. Yeah, Sweden have problems right now. Someone's pressing claim on Sweden. I might have just jumped on Sweden while he is weak, but he still have all of his allies, so. It's not great. Actually, Sweden currently doesn't have much claims at all, only just counts. Not claims, but allies, I should say. Okay, how much money do we need to create this duchy? I think like 100 ducats, yeah? Yeah, so we could totally now afford it. And this guy only have 700 army, so I'm gonna be able to get rid of him just using resonance if he's not gonna raise any holy orders. So what I'm gonna do is just create this Duchy of Karelia. Gonna give it to my vassal who I have in here. It's gonna be a mess, but at least the duchy gonna exist, so that's something. And you're gonna have a de jure claim anyways. So yeah, these guys are just vassals under wrong people, unfortunately. Not much I could do about this, but at least now we have a jure claim, right? Yeah. So I'll just go and press it right away. I should have actually started moving my troops in, but oh well. Okay, so 700 against 1300. Should be an easy battle, and there is a marriage ready. Let's go and do this. Ducats or prestige? Considering that we spent so much money, I would prefer to have some back right now. And we're already almost at the 2000 prestige cap, so whatever. Okay, you're not raising any holy orders. That's great. It better not do this. Population of Halogaland has been converted to the Resting Fate. Where is that? Halogaland, probably here. Yeah. Great. Keep converting, but I still have this high moral authority. Oh, this event again. He's not gonna be able to join, so just give me money if you can. I don't want you to join any of my wars. Yeah. He not really joined, but okay. Satrap Navid of Somaliland has provided me with proof that someone is slandering me. Just try to state of factions. Oh, talking about factions, we actually have some. Someone want to install this guy in my place. Even though he have like no claim whatsoever. And someone wants to lower crown authority. Don't you dare. Don't you dare rebel on me. Actually having this extra resonance also gonna help slightly with factions. Because it's gonna be counted towards my personal army size. Also, any chance we have a siege leader finally after so many years? No. That's terrible. The constant surges of adrenaline increase heart rates. Make me wary, it's not as fun being angry as it used to be. So I'm not wroth anymore. Increased heart rate? Are you, like, concerned about getting a heart attack? Yeah, you're getting slightly old, so that's probably possible, but I wouldn't be so concerned about that yet. Yeah, this host totally not going anywhere, and they're just... As this shit recovered, they're now just burning it again. Okay, we need to do something with that. How much men could I race personally 4500, and they have 4500. And there are tons of cavalry. No. I don't think I'm gonna be spending my money or my troops on that then. Just burn down whatever you want. It's not my personal holding anyway. Okay, finish this siege and let me finish the war. He's not calling in anyone. And not raising any hall orders. Perfect. So we're just gonna pick up another one. Catholic vassal. Let's hope he's gonna be dealt with. So, another one province into our Empire of Scandinavia. Up to 52%. Cool. So, now we need to start focusing on this region. We already have everything. Everything on the south border. So, de jure. Yeah, just all of these small guys, including Pomerania and Denmark. It's nice that we also, I haven't noticed when looking first time, but all of these small islands are also technically are de jure parts of Empire of Scandinavia, so I would need to focus on them as well. But yeah, let's go and start moving our retinue here first, and then we'll see if we could attack anyone. Like Bergslagen. Oh, there's Pomeranian revolt happening. That is actually might be quite convenient. Also, I almost got a freaking error or something. I don't know for what, but it shows that recording is still going, so let's hope that everything is fine. Actually, should I just try to... I don't know. Everything should be fine. Yeah, demand reconversion. He's gonna listen to me. Population of Nordland has been converted to Zoroastrian. Okay, so all of this duchy of Nidaros starting to get converted. That's great. What the heck? Why the heck you refused if I have such good relations with you? I could just demand your conversion this way, and you're gonna say yes. So that's quite weird. Okay, you're moving. Unfortunately, capital of Sweden is currently sieged, so I couldn't declare a de jure claim on you. Marriage between my daughter and my nephew. He's a quick one, and she's a quick one. Yeah, of course. People still voting for this guy to be my heir, even though he's ugly. Excuse me, but at least he's nice. He's having a decent martial skill. So, who's gonna be nice to attack in here? Probably someone for the de jure claim. I could press a de jure claim on Sweden. Oh, and now you're allied with King of Denmark, of course. As soon as I'm planning to attack you. Let's move you in somewhere here. Bergslagen, how powerful are you? 2500 troops, that's quite a few. Nice. We got a son from our concubine, but she actually died during childbirth. God damn it. Let's go and find a new one. Unfortunately, we already sold out the queen. So, we don't really have much other prestigious women here, right? Anyone I could get prestige for? What do I need to sort by? By, like, rank? I don't know. Let's go and look for like last fault list. Or just sort by age. 26? Sounds fine. At least you're right religion. So let's hope you're not gonna be trying to kill me. Okay, so who could be taken here? Okay. You're declaring a rebellion on Orkney? Why he's not fighting off? I thought he have like a pretty sizable army, yeah. He totally does, but he's not fighting off. That's strange. Okay, should we just try to press the de jure claim on Sweden? Oh, excuse me. How on earth you have 3,000 troops now? Host did not manage to succeed. Oh. What the heck? Why you raised Teutonic Order if you're fighting with Catholics? That seems stupid. Yes, these two guys are Catholic. What's this third war? Oh, never mind. My vassal actually decided to declare a holy war on you. Okay, good luck with that. Catholic rebels risen up somewhere. In here, really? 1600 troops. Okay, for that I might actually consider raising my personal armies. So let's go and do this. My vassal probably not gonna be able to fight off this Teutonic Order. And we're probably gonna lose some moral authority for that. Oh, really? You're just willing to pass through this host right away? Yeah. Please don't. Stupid idea. Let's get some leaders in charge. Actually have direct leader, so let's get you here. Some people in the flanks, including me, and even my heir. Let's hope he's not gonna get killed. So. Okay, Orkney finished the rebellion. You have 1500 troops. You have... Oh, you have Bergslagen as an ally. What kind of bullshit is that? I have a feeling this host not gonna leave any freaking time soon. He's gonna pillage and pillage and pillage and pillage. And 4500 is... a little bit too many. Probably not gonna be able to win with my personal army, because they have a lot of cavalry in here. Oh. Okay, Sweden. You're still fighting with a host, right? No, you actually managed to fight it off. Or maybe you lost, I don't know. What about this holy war? It takes a land, Agermanland, Livermore, and Medelpad. So like, five of my vassals combined together for this holy war. Interesting. But they're still gonna get wrecked. Look at these armies. Army sizes. Oh, great. I just became craven in this battle. My son? No. You're not gonna become content. Not acceptable. Yeah, I don't like holy wars. Or I do like holy wars, but I don't want to declare any right now. You already know how painful as it was previous time, but now we couldn't even raise any money from the Jews. So that would be a problem to fight off. Oh, now we just move to the next province. Okay. That's starting to get annoying. I'm just gonna go and raise my vassal troops. And start to fight, you stupid jerk. Actually, yeah, that's why I want to create a freaking kingdom. Just raise all the troops in one province, fight off the host, and we all good. But no, now I need to rally them all from all over the map. That's kind of painful. So, Aland, you're probably gonna lose your holy war, and you're gonna make our fate suffer. Suffer these penalties, you jerk. We need another one commander, let's get a new one. You're not receiving much. Even though I have, actually, I've probably been forgetting about taking a lot of concubines as previous characters. That's why I do not have much children. And that's what that's why I'm not producing much commanders with decent combat skills. So I would need to start paying more attention now to that, if possible. Okay. Oh, 41 boss. Actually gonna be enough to take all of this. Not quite. Not quite, but Suomi could provide me with some more. So let's go and take all of this man here. Move to Laanema. You go to Laanema, and you go to Laanema. And let's fucking kill this stupid host finally. Before he's gonna burn down all the holdings in our realm. This 180 stack could just go away. Actually don't need that many of them anymore. Okay, how many cavalry we have in here? Just from... Oh, I've accidentally sent my retinue in here as well. Okay. Oh well. is already in here. The rise of the Shia. I've already seen this event. And I don't know, I don't think there's any Shias on the map right now. So yeah, let's just go and fight off this host. Should be able to win, I hope. Yeah. It would be also nice to like capture some of them to at least get some payout from them pillaging my lands, but no, there's like no real reason for me to fight off just to prevent the future pillaging, but it's actually already time for me to have a break, guys, so I'm gonna do this, and we're gonna continue in the next episode, and let's hope I'm gonna have enough courage to attack someone in this region next time. So, if you enjoyed watching this, you could leave a like, if you want to see more, subscribe, and if you want to leave a comment, definitely do it, and I would answer as soon as I could. See you later, guys. Bye-bye.